We continue our focus on eternal life because that's the right focus to have right now. And we say that eternal life cannot be subjugated in any way, cannot be subjugated. just shocked by unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just allowing unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just accepting unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just delighting in unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just loving unsubjugated eternal life in wow. Just abiding in unsubjugated eternal life in wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Eternal life cannot be subjugated. Okay, so there's no sequence of subjugation taking place. There's zero sequence of subjugating taking place, even though all this realm of so-called death seems to be a sequence of subjugating eternal life to non-eternal life. It's simply a pretense. It's not really happening in terms of reality. So just there's just unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just loving unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just loving unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Cannot be subjugated to something else at all, right? So this is a practice that I'm doing today. And it's a focus that has great hope to it, actually. And you realize, hey, the eternal life is possible. It's not subjugated to anything else. So I can experience unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just experiencing unsubjugated eternal life in wow. Just loving unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just loving unsubjugating eternal life in wow. It can't be subjected to anything else. It cannot be subjected to anything else. It cannot be subjected to impermanence. Eternal life cannot be subjected to impermanence. It's unsubjugating. It can't be subjugated, brought under the influence and effect of, to be subjugated, unsubjugating eternal life in wow. There's just unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Okay, so this is a really powerful focus for these times. Today is, I think it's the 13th. Let me take a look. It's the 14th. So we're really quite close now, just a week away from, a little over a week away from the 22nd, this time period here where I feel it's essential that we get on the right side, so to speak, of this equation. In terms of whether we believe in impermanence or eternal life, in non-eternal life or eternal life. Eternal life cannot be subjugated in any way. No sequence of subjugation. Therefore, there's only eternal life. There's just one eternal lifing, actually. So we really need to get comfortable with this. So in practicing this today, I felt this is like supremely, supremely helpful. On the other hand, it's stressful. I feel like long haulers came back on me today, extremely bad. Feel extremely weak and tired. So it's sort of it's oscillating right now. And then other information was given to me today that grace helps you realize just how terrible this world really is, just how awful it is. And someone with information about that gave me this information today, and I can't even pass the information on. It's so terrible what's going on. So it makes you really motivated to say, hey, I'm preparing myself to experience unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life in wow. That which is unsubjugating cannot be subjugated to anything else. Eternal life cannot be subjugated to anything else. Therefore, it's unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Okay, so let's try it again. Just shocked by unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just allowing unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just accepting unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just delighting in unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just loving unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just abiding in unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life in wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life in wow, wow, wow. And I was doing this driving along. I felt at sometimes like I was in this ambience of unsubjugating eternal lifing. It's right there, and we can feel it. We can feel it. It's like, oh, wow. So, you know, we are certainly in the ballpark here, and yet the practice is stressful because it's reversing very deeply entrenched fear-based belief system that we have, that eternal life has become subjugated to not impermanence, non-eternal lifing, which has never happened, actually, and can never happen. And yet we believe it. So it is stressful, and yet the world is, you know, looking back, I cannot get into the negativity of the world, because that would, that's not a good thing to do, to mix this is extreme negativity with extreme positivity. So I can't really comment on it, but I'm aware of it, certainly aware of it. If we talked about it, it would be too much. I mean, what this person told me today, I just said, oh no, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? This is actually how I said, yeah. Oh my God. You know, it's just like, holy cow. It's just, you know, people don't want to think about it. This casual affluence attitude that we have in the world, we don't want anything to disturb that. And yet in this dream of impermanence, it's really a show we're putting on to try to convince the Prime Creator that it's really awful, that the Prime Creator is subjugated to this impermanence and ruination. So we're trying really hard to convince the Prime Creator that, and so it's awful. It's really awful what's going on. Doesn't work. So we need no longer believe that we're subjugated to non-eternal lifing, so we can accept just unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. That which is continuously just eternal lifing. It's never subjugated or subjugating to anything else. There's no sequence of subjugating taking place at all. No sequence of it whatsoever ever taking place. And there's no special cases of subjugated eternal lifing. No special cases whatsoever. Not one. Not one. So just loving unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. 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 So I had to sleep at rest today. Just because I feel like I'm almost dying, you know, the feeling is, it's really, but what's really, you know, the world isn't continuous, it's continuously this pretense of dying. And then this notion that this is real is dying. So there is some dying taking place, as it were. The delusion that non-eternal life is actually real, that certainly is fading away. Just loving unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Now, there is a need to go really fast right now. So this is why these practices are like a full-on sprint. So when you're doing a full-on sprint, you're going to feel tired. The freeway is the keyway to unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. We're working to get real fast to get onto this freeway, so to speak, and get away from the troubled situation, really, that's going on in the world. No matter how much is brought to light about it, nothing happens. It keeps taking place. It's like an avalanche. You say, oh, you name the avalanche, there's an avalanche there. It doesn't stop the avalanche. You know, it should tell you, hey, wait a minute, I gotta, you know, get away from this avalanche. It's an avalanche of ruination, you might say. So we're saying, just loving unsubjugating eternal life, and wow, preconditioning ourselves to accept this. So just shocked by unsubjugating eternal lifing. Well, let's say you're in a situation where you're experiencing this unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. We might first be very shocked by it. And then we can say, well, just allowing this, I'll just allow it to be this way. Just allowing unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. And then you might say a little later in a while, you might say, you know, I just accept this. I accept this. Okay. So just accepting unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. And then you'll go through a progression where you say, you know what, I just delighting in this. I'm just delighting in unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. This finding just delighting in it. And then you say, just loving it, just loving unsubjugating eternal life, and wow. And then finally, just abiding in unsubjugating eternal life, and wow. Then ultimately, just, this is all there is, just unsubjugating eternal life, and wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life, and wow. So indeed, this is going at an incredibly fast pace at this point, a full-on sprint. But it's necessary. So something about these times right now, I was warned about them. And the time between the 9th of July and the 22nd of July is an extremely important time for us to, we have to accelerate what we're doing. So you may be hearing this and saying, wow, this is just, I don't know, it seems so much. It is so much. Absolutely, it is. But there's a state of desperation, I would say, in the world. The world should be desperate right now. They should be very desperate to set our allegiance where we want it. Is our allegiance with unsubjugating eternal lifing, or is it with this pretense of impermanence, that somehow we can subjugate eternal life to non-eternal life, to limitation and ruination? Where's our allegiance? We just have to choose, you know, what our allegiance is right now. It's very, very important because these times are accelerating, and it's beyond what we're aware of, what's going on in the world. It's much worse than we realize. So we're saying, hey, set our allegiance with unsubjugating eternal life, and wow, unsubjugating eternal life, and wow, just unsubjugating eternal life, and wow. And get used to hearing yourself with this. And it's working for me. It's working. It's like, hey, you know, it's like it's gotten easier and easier, this practicing. At first, it was very difficult. I woke up this morning, very bad dreams. I was stuck in this nightmare and didn't know what to do about it. But then asked for, prayed for a practice. And then this practice came to be. But I didn't understand it so much at first. And it was very difficult. But the more I did it, the more I started to tune into it and say, oh, this is fantastic practice. It's a way of acclimatizing myself to unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Okay. Unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. It's a way to talk myself into it, to get used to it, get a feeling like, yeah, I can handle a realm. I was thinking like a death-free realm. And it's just, there's no place in that realm where the eternal life is being subjugated to non-eternal life at all. So it's just unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow, just that. And I'm saying, yeah, I can accept this. I just, you know, I'm shocked, allowing, accepting, delighting in, loving, and abiding in, and just that, just this. And so we really need to go past this ideal of casual affluence, which we have had in Western society, United States especially, over the last 100 years. And we've all been acting like, you know, we're living in this paradise of casual affluence. And we must realize that this is not what it seems to be. And it's about to, you know, come tumbling down. So, you know, we have to realize that was not the answer. It was not the answer. It was never the answer. So I never bought into this. I never bought into this. It's not it. It's trying to find a way to be happy within this dream or this play of limitation and ruination. So it doesn't really work. It doesn't last. It's not it. So we need to now state to ourselves what is really it, unsubjugating eternal life, and wow, just unsubjugating eternal life, and wow, that's what I really want. So people are not so casually affluent right now, the mood and the attitude in the Silicon Valley, it's still prevalent, but not really. There's no middle class really left here. It's just the wealthy tech people. That's a different attitude. But before, we just had this attitude of you know, it's kind of like, hey, you know, this is God's world. I'm good with God. You know, God's given me everything that wonderful in this world. I can just, you know, go around and just enjoy God's world. That's what I'm supposed to be doing, et cetera, blah, blah, blah. Sort of a hybrid of Christianity, of the idea that this is God's world. God created humans, created everything in this world for the benefit of humans, to make humans happy. And so we're just living this, you know, we're just living on all this grace of God here. Just and everything, you know, it will be just, our lives will be wonderful. Everybody's lives will be wonderful. We can't imagine that anyone could really be otherwise. And, you know, God's taking care of everyone. It's making sure that nothing, you know, nothing can bad can befall everyone here, and all this kind of stuff. But that's actually not really true. This attitude is causing so many people to be unaware of what's going on in the world, in terms they can't imagine that bad stuff happens here in the world. Really, is it? No, you know, I'm just, let's take a nice walk, you know, and beautiful here, safe neighborhoods and everything, and, you know, find out what's really going on in other places, what's actually coming here, and you realize, you know, all that's, you know, coming to an end in many ways. And it's so the world is not that this wonderful place that we assume it to be. Very naive. That's extremely, extremely naive. It's a terrible place by design. It's death front loaded with so-called lifing, casual affluencing, but behind that is really death. And God did not, Jesus said, God has nothing to do with this world, making this world, this universe even, nothing to do with it. That we're trying to convince the prime creator that it's subject to this ruination, limitation, ruination. But it's all just a put on, a pretense by us. So, you know, we shouldn't be so naive to think that all is well with this world. All is not well with this world. that's an understatement. It's by design. It's a huge ruination situation coming about by design, by our design, to convince the prime creator that its so-called perfection is backloaded with this ruination, which is not true. So this unsubjugating eternal lifing, that's reality. That's the prime creator. It's not backloaded with any subjugation to ruination or limitation whatsoever, any subjugation in any way. It's perfect freedom. It's absolute perfect freedoming. There's no subjugation of eternal lifing. Zero. And that's reality. So we better prove to ourselves that we can get used to this, because we have to get used to it. You know, it's either that, if we're not on that path, you know, we're going to be on the path of extreme naivete and suffer from the troubles in this world, which are, you know, really bad. I've had a couple conversations with people, one yesterday, one today, with people telling me about what's really going on, and they're not joking. I mean, they're in position to actually know these things. And so I listen to and hear, and says, well, that's what's really going on. It is not this wonderful, casually affluent culture and society that'll last forever, and everyone's, you know, so it's not like that. But everyone's pretending that it is, you know, pretty much. We gotta keep up appearances, you know. I ask people, how do you feel underneath? They say, I'm absolutely scared out of my mind, you know, but I gotta keep pretending like, oh, this, you know, this lasts forever. I mean, everything is just terrific, just great. There is grace helping us move towards realization and acceptance of unsubjugating eternal lifing. That certainly is true. That certainly is true. So that is present in various ways in this world for everyone that asks for help. So it's not like we need to panic, but we certainly have to imagine if we end up in some place that's so much better than we expect, where it seems like nothing is subjugated to death, nothing is subjugated to ruination, nothing is subjugated, you know, to limitation and ruination at all. You know, what will we freak out? You know, well, here we would say, you know what? There's a certain amount of freak out for sure that will happen. So I better start practicing talking to myself, inner dialoguing with myself, just shocked by unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Okay, well, that's a legitimate response to it. I'm shocked by it. So we're not naive enough to think that we wouldn't be shocked by this. Of course, we would be shocked by it. I experienced such a death-free realm, and I couldn't stay there because I was became psychologically very shocked, overly shocked, and started panicking. It was so unexpected. I said, how could this be? I couldn't, didn't have a framework, psychological framework for it. Now I do, but for sure you'd be shocked by this, for sure. So, but if you can practice like this practicing, then you can say, well, you know what? I can dissipate the shock. If I just stay very, keep on being very resolute about it, I can just start dissipating the shock. So after a while, start feeling, well, just allowing this, unsubjugating eternal life and wow. I can just get to say, okay, well, I'm allowing it. I'm allowing it now. That's just how I feel. I'm allowing it. Nothing more or less. And then you can get to a feeling of like, well, I'm just accepting it now. I'm in acceptance of it now. And then ultimately, you start going into, I'm delighting in it now. It's just really delight. I'm allowing myself to delight in this. And then I'm just really loving this. So allowing myself to really love it. And then I'm allowing myself to just have just feeling just a total abidance in this. And then finally, ultimately, we will accept that. There's nothing other than this. This is it. So if we can train ourselves, we know we can train ourselves in that direction, then we won't freak out. We won't panic. We wouldn't panic. So obviously the goal here is to find ourselves in a better situation than what's going on here in this world, a better psychological situation, to find ourselves somehow getting reacquainted with unsubjugating eternal lifing. Because we certainly don't want to keep hoping, putting our faith in what's taking place on this planet right now. It's a whole bunch of trouble. The fact that we know we can practice in this way, we can work with our psyche, our reactions, and gradually calm them down, based on getting acquainted with something that is so much better than what we're used to, so much better. And that's what we have to aim for that right now. We cannot try to fix the problems as we're right now. That's not something that's going to happen. It's way more out of control than we realize. So the idea that, oh no, someone's just going to snap their fingers, and pass a law and everything will be fine, and that's not happening at all. So we have to realize, it's up to us now to aim higher, to aim higher, aim higher. We have brighter prospects than just mere casual affluence in this world. We have to aim higher than that. So how do you do that? Well, by practicing, for sure. For sure, by proving, knowing you can practice, knowing you can calm yourself down if you find yourself in a situation that's vastly better than you expected. That's the toughest thing to deal with. It's very, very difficult. We think we can handle things if we're in a worse situation. We'll get by somehow. But what if we go into a situation that's way better than we expect? That then becomes, psychologically very, very difficult, but doable. We can do it. So, we're rapidly, coming upon, coming close to this now. So we need to be able to just shock by unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Just allowing unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Just accepting unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Just delighting in unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Just loving unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Just abiding in unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Just unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. Just unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. So the feeling I have now that doesn't seem to be affected by anything I eat or sleep or nothing. It's really a feeling of depletion, and it's sort of is like feeling the way that the world actually is, you might say. This is like an accurate feeling of what's really going on in the world, you might say, and it's just So I don't try to, fight against it necessarily, but I'm just looking for a psychological way to shift to something that is unsubjugating, eternal lifing, at least some representation of that, some feel of that, so that I don't have to keep feeling this world the way that it's feeling. This world is in deep trouble in terms of portraying ruination, limitation, and ruination in a very, very intense way, really. But grace is still working. Grace is still working. I come across people all the time, and they tell me how they got this and that, and you realize that that grace is working in their life. It's amazing. It really is happening. But still, we want to, be free of this malaise, you might say. This malaise, like I say, this COVID malaise, is really, it's the malaise in the world. It's just how we're reacting to this overall malaise in the world. And if you're aware of it, you can feel it, and you say, wow, I don't want this. So when I feel this, it gets me to actually practice more, because I realize, hey, I don't want to feel this way. Right? They want to feel this way. And I kept telling people this is coming in the world, and they said, nah, well, this is going to last forever, this casual happens. Well, you look throughout history, it's happened over and over and over again. And it just ruination just keeps coming nonstop throughout history. So we get on the freeway is the key way. The freeway is the key way. Get onto this freeway, so to speak. You're on the freeway that's just going to take you past all this horrible stuff. Let's say there's a city, and in the city is just so much horrible stuff going on. It could be any city in the United States or across the border or various places in the world. But so the in order to escape all this terrible, horrible stuff that's going on in this ghetto, you jump on the freeway, and the freeway just takes you right through it really quickly, and poof, and you're out of that city. You're gone. It's the way to escape. It's the way to escape. So we need to get on the freeway, okay, and escape all the mischief that's going on, and it is certainly going on. But again, in driving today, I could feel it's a gorgeous day here, by the way, in California. It's just super foggy. It's been super foggy at the coast, warm inland. The mixture of the two is just wow. I mean, there's this really cool breeze, right? It's a wonderful cool breeze. And the day just felt like honey or something, liquid honey. It's so nice. And but you get this feel of just this sort of ambience of eternal lifing. I say, wow, it's possible just to feel this, just as we're here, still here in this world, we can feel this actually, this ambience. It's experienceable. So there is some hope that we can get into this experiencing. There have been some that have done this, and they tell of their success in this to us. So certainly we have to believe it's possible. It is certainly possible for us to do this. So this practicing helps ease us past our paranoia and ease us into experiencing this ambience, this eternal lifing ambience that doesn't feel subjugated at all. There's no subjugating. It's not subjugated to anything else. It's not subjugated. It can't be subjugated to anything else. There's the feeling. It cannot be subjugated to anything else. Wow. Whereas in this world, it seems like everything is subjugated to something, right? It's a dream of subjugation. It's a dream of subjugation. Time, space, process, etc. Subjugation. Eternal life is not subject to any subjugation at all. So the experience is so marvelous. Wow. It doesn't need any confirmation at all. It doesn't need any validation, you might say. It's self-validating. Doesn't need any validation from any subjugation. Subjugation always demands validation. Was this valid? Eternal life is not, if no subjugationing, doesn't need any validationing at all. Just chakra, zero validationing. Wow. So you don't have to validate it. So you don't have to validate it. Very important. You're not required to validate it. It's self-validating. It's self-validating. Neither naming nor explaining. Self-validating. Wow. Neither naming nor explaining. It's just self-validating. Wow. Just loving. Neither naming nor explaining. Self-validating. Wow. So neither naming nor explaining. Just self-validating. Wow. Neither naming nor explaining. Just self-validating. Wow. So again, we're going real fast. But just give yourself the experience of this. Experience the speed of this. Like saying, wow. You know, it's like we're really getting out of Dodge here in a hurry. That's great. So neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. So you don't need to try to validate with naming it. You don't need to try to validate with explaining it. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. So just loving, unsubjugating, eternal life. And wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. So, yeah. I mean, it's kind of like, I expected these times to be difficult, so I'm not really shocked. I'm feeling so lousy. I've been working really hard. There's no question about that. But the long haulers, it comes back on you. Wow, it just feels like you're on zero battery, kind of out of gas on zero battery. And there's really no way to get, you know, it doesn't seem like you're recharging your battery. It doesn't seem to recharge. It's like a phone, and it's like, you know, on like 5% battery, and you can't get it recharged. We're trying to fill up tires yesterday. Couldn't get air in the tires. It wouldn't, you know, keep filling up the in fact, one valve was, every time we tried to fill it up, it would lose pressure. It would lose more than was put in. So that's the sign of the times right now, right? So it was started at 72, and I realized what was going on. Someone else didn't. And I said, hey, you got to stop. Stop, stop. I checked it, and it was at 70. And he kept trying. It was down to 69. So the more you kept trying to put air in the tire, the lower the air pressure was going. Really amazing. I said, hey, stop, man. You just don't even try to put air in that tire. And we finally found a place. We got bumped it up to 75, but we couldn't get any higher than that. Supposed to be 80. Couldn't get it up to 80. So the gas stations, the compressors and the air hose and stuff, they can't even put enough air in the tires right now. It's sort of like that. We feel like we've got flat tire, and we can't get, and we try to fill it up, and it just gets flatter. You know, it's really like that. So if we struggle with the world right now, well, things will just get worse. We'll feel even worse. Whereas before we thought, oh no, you know, we just wave a magic wand, you know, and everything's great, that kind of thing. It's not. It gets trying to fix it. It gets worse. The more you try to fix it, the worse it gets. So we're just turning to neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. Unsubjugating, eternal lifing. Wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. Just loving, unsubjugating, eternal lifing. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. So hopefully, just hearing this, you realize there is a way to prepare for this. There is a way to you know, go in the right direction. And we're not doomed at all. And you're actually, you know, hearing it, and it's being done right here. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. Not just loving, unsubjugating, eternal life. And wow, I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. I need do nothing. I am light. Wow. Right? So you can just say that to yourself. And it's powerful medicine, super powerful medicine. It's not fixing this dream, so to speak, but it is preparing for us to experiencing that where we're not really touched by the trouble what's going on here somehow. It's hard to explain, but just neither naming nor explaining. Okay, don't need to explain it. Just naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. Okay. I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow, neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow, just loving, unsubjugating, eternal life. And wow, I need do nothing. I am light. Wow, I need do nothing. I am light. Wow, I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow, and you go on and on. So you have to realize this is possible here. So that this is helpful. Just to realize you may not be able to do it quite like this, or maybe you can. But at least you're aware, hey, this is possible. This is really possible. And you know, just doing it while I'm working, you know, today, going driving Highway 17, you know, doing this and that, going all over, work. I'm doing all this practicing right in the midst of this, and even talking with people, I'm practicing, and socialized visiting people, I was still practicing. So I'm practicing more intensely than before. I realized that what's at stake here. So neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. 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 It's a four-step practice. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. Just naming nor, neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. Just loving, unsubjugating eternal life, and wow. I am light, I am light, I am light, wow. I need to do nothing, I am light, wow. Like that. Very effective practicing, wow. And we're told, you know, by the avatar, so said, if you're just feeling so tired, like you're just exhausted, like you've been running this race, and you just put everything you had into it, he says, that's really, really good. That's great. That means you are really close to success. So don't panic if you feel this way. Don't panic. You know, it's better than strolling around acting like you're in, you know, casual and affluence land forever, that kind of thing. He says that's not the way to go about it. You should be practicing. You could still stroll about. I mean, when in Rome, do as Romans do. So everybody keeping up appearances here, for sure. Where I live, everyone's definitely keeping up appearances. And I'm doing that. But I'm practicing, like, intensely. Like, going into CVS, so I'm practicing intensely. You go into any store, any place, just, you know, practice intensely. Yeah. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. Just loving, unsubjugating, eternal life, and 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 wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. I am light, I am light, I am light, wow. So it's the time when, you know, try to just practice at all moments of the day. I'm definitely putting more effort into it now. A lot more. Kind of like a sprint, like an all-out sprint to get to that freeway. The freeway really is the key way. You don't want to get lost on the streets of the ghetto right now, right? You don't want to be wandering in the back streets of the ghetto, right? That's not the place to be right now. You want to be on the freeway. One benefit is I don't have any assets, so I don't have anything to lose. So I'm not thinking about how to protect my assets. So maybe this is like a super beneficial. I guess the grace always told me, don't worry about that. Don't worry about that. You know, it's a good thing for you. I said, but you know, I got no future at all. You know, how can I not worry? He says, you'll see. So, you know, if people have assets, they're going to be fighting to protect those assets right now, right? They're going to do anything to fix the world, to struggle, to maintain those assets and protect them and all this kind of stuff. I don't have any assets. I have nothing to protect, nothing to fight for. Nothing to be concerned about in terms of like my house, what am I going to do with my mortgage and car, my savings, my investments, you know, all these kind of things, that worldliness, all this stuff. I don't have anything like that. So don't even have to think about it. Not even thinking about any of that stuff. Don't even have much of a life to protect at this point, right? My age, you know, young lives, people will say, well, I got this life, I got to protect this. You know, I've got a lot of life to live. And I'm saying, yeah, just, so neither naming nor explaining, just self-evidenting, wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-evidenting, wow. just loving, non-subjecting eternal life in wow. Not subjugating anything at all. Non-subjugating eternal life in wow. Eternal life is not subjugating itself to anything else. Right? And this is neither naming nor explaining self, just self-evidenting wow. Just non-subjugating eternal life in wow, non-subjugating eternal life in wow, non-subjugating eternal life in wow, non-subjugating eternal life in wow. So even though I'm almost like passing out from how I feel, I could still bring the practicing, you see. I can still bring the clarity and still bring the practicing very clearly. Because I'm used to doing that, absolutely. Neither naming nor explaining to self-evidenting, wow, this loving, unsubjugating, eternal life, and wow, I am light, I am light, I am light, wow, I need do nothing, I am light, wow, I need do nothing, I am light, wow, I need say nothing, I am light, wow, I need explain nothing, I am light, wow. I am light, I am light, I am light, wow. Just self-evidenting, I am light, wow. Just self-evidenting, I am light, wow. So it's just, just self-validating, I am light, wow. You can say self-validating, wow. Neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating, wow. I am light, I am light, I am light, wow. I need to do nothing, just self-validating, wow. I need no validation. I'm self-validating. Wow. Eternal life is self-validating. It doesn't need something else to validate it, you see. It doesn't need anything else to validate what it is. So it's just self-validating eternal life in wow. 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 So I didn't take a Tylenol today. I was feeling just horrible. I said, nah, let's just rest and see. I don't think it's going to do much anyway. It might help a little bit, but still, it's good to be in touch with suffering and realize, where it's coming from. So we're not, 100% in the camp of saying that, what we're experiencing is just a projection of our own projection. It's not, it's not quite like that. It could be to some extent. I mean, you don't want to say that's not true, but there's a collective effort going on here. Okay, and so we're under enormous pressure to not spoil the effect. So we're trying to convince the prime creator this is all real, that our acting is real and not an act. So anyone who goes off script and says, hey, I'm just acting, ha ha ha, that is frowned upon here, very intensely frowned upon. In fact, you'll make yourself an absolute pariah if you do that. They say in other words, they don't want anyone doing that because they think the prime creator will say, hey, wait a minute, why is that person acting in such a way? They're saying, oh, this is just an act, it's not real, ha ha ha. The prime creator will say, hey, maybe it is an act, maybe I'm just being fooled. That's what we think is going to happen. But the fact is the prime creator knows that this is an act, always has. And so it's always known this. It's not bought into this in the slightest bit. So nobody can spoil some spell that we're casting on the prime creator. We haven't cast any spell at all on the prime creator. But nevertheless, people still view you as a pariah for doing it. They weren't too pleased with Jesus, were they? There is enormous pressure. And those people who are acting intensely with intense conviction, it tends to pull you into that orbit. We tend to get pulled into the orbit of doing that. So it's more than we're just merely projecting upon the world our own attitudes. It seems to be much more than that. But maybe that's just one way of helping people saying that, and I can't argue against it. I'm just saying from my perspective, this is a vast collective effort that's going on here to try to try to convince the prime creator that it is actually subject to limitation and ruination, and we're putting on this big show, and we don't, everyone tells everybody else, don't go off script, don't go off script, don't go off script. You know, just try to go off script and you'll see how people react to you. They're not going to like you at all. For instance, when I had COVID, first COVID, I think I was supposed to die, but I didn't. I was able to minimize the trouble. And so when I came out back into the world, it was really a freak out. I was gone for a month or more. I didn't see anyone. And I started trying to reintegrate myself back into the world. And people like looking at me like in very funny, odd ways. And I realized they're saying, you're supposed to be dead. What are you doing here? That's what happened. It was really quite amazing to experience that. I've experienced that quite a few times. I was supposed to be dead. And grace minimized the impact upon me. So I'm still here. But people like say, wait a minute. This is weird. How come you're still here? You're not supposed to be here anymore. Subconsciously, I could tell. I could read their reactions to me. It's very odd. Very, very odd. And recently, also, people have been reacting to me in odd ways. Like, you know, you're supposed to, like, you know, be subject to ruination, and you're not going to be. That's not right. You know, that's not right. They're kind of like saying, hey, you're going to do something that's not right. You know, this office, we don't do that here, you know, that kind of thing. So you get a lot of pressure from other people to say, hey, you know, you're supposed to stay on script here. So it's not quite this easy as just saying, oh, all I got to do is stop projecting unhappiness on everybody now, and everything will be gloriously, wonderfully happy. People are not necessarily so happy when you're that way at all. They say, whoa, you know, you're not supposed to be doing that. Get back to the script here, this ruination script. Come on. We've almost got the prime creator convinced, and you're going to ruin it for all of us? That's the meta message that you get. Not everybody liked the avatar, actually. She said a lot of people were negative. And she says that. So, you know, Jesus, look at the negativity he experienced. A lot of negativity there. A lot of resistance. It's, hey, you're busting the script here, man. You can't do that. God's going to wise up to the spell we're casting on God. And again, we're trying to cast a spell on God. We're trying to sin, trying to cast a spell on God. But we're having zero success in this. So how can we say we're sinners? We're not really sinners, because we're failing. We're trying to be sinners, yeah. But we're completely failing at it. So, you know, there's nothing to forgive, because we can't ever have any success at all in trying to cast a spell upon God. Zero. So, you know, to say that I'm a sinner, it's not really true. Saying I'm trying to be a sinner, but I'm failing. So in some way, the church, by convinced, saying you got to confess your sins, you're a sinner, they're saying, well, you are sinning against God. So you are. They're really in a backhanded way, reinforcing the notion that you can sin against God, which is actually you know, the primary delusion. As Jesus says, there's no sins to forgive. Forgive yourself for believing that you could ever sin against God. That's the only forgiveness we need, is to forgive ourselves, our belief that we could ever sin against God. Forgive yourself for believing that. That's what he tells us, and he's quite accurate about that. Mercy. Yeah. Again, we're not disavowing the idea that if you just are giving perfect freedom and forgiveness to yourself, to everyone, that you won't, your functioning may not, you know, if it may indeed provide you with this experience of heaven on earth, so to speak. We're not saying it doesn't. We're giving sort of additional context here early. But I mean, look, there've been plenty of people in the world who, those who were, accept eternal life for themselves. And you look at the world, and 100% minus are not doing that at all. So it's not like it fixed the world or cured everybody at all. Yeah. It's just that they experienced unsubjugating, eternal lifing. But the rest of the people, they're still continuing to experience, you know, to put on this act that it's not real. You know, this impermanence is real. They're still putting on that act. So it's not like just because you stop projecting your attitude on everyone that this is going to heal everybody. It doesn't seem to be what's happening. Could be wrong, but some say this is just all your own dream. So, you know, you have an unhealed dream. That's what you're experiencing. It might be a little too glib. There could be some truth to that, or truth in some way to look at it in that way. Possible. We don't want to say it's not possible. But indeed, these times, you know, I mean, how can you say that you're really, everything that's happening in this world is you're just, you yourself are causing it, you know? I don't know. It's a little difficult to see it that way. Because, you know, we it's just, you know, they say it's all a dream. It's really a scheme. It's a little different than a dream. I think that the term dream is misleading. It's not really a dream, it's a scheme. That's what the revelation, February 10th, 2020 on Revelation showed me. It's a scheme. It's a program that we're all working on. We're volunteering to work on so many, many facets of the oneness of spirit are working on this scheme, designing, testing, assessing this scheme to try and convince the prime creator to self-destruct. So it's acting a dream? Not really. Not really. It's more of a scheming than a dreaming. Now, our imagination is certainly being used in this scheme. It is certainly being used to a tremendous extent. Tremendous extent. But, we're looking at it this way, that we're acting. We're putting on an act. But not just us. All of us are putting on an act here. And we're volunteering to do this, to play these roles, and to... certainly our collective imagination has a template, kind of like an algorithm that our imagination goes through. It's like we imagine imagination like a current, and like a power current, and this power current, like electricity or something, goes through this computer, which has these algorithms and programs on it. And these algorithms and programs then put on a screen, a world, a universe on the screen. It's sort of more like that. Is going on. And then we have these like avatars that we identify with in this algorithm program screen projection, that we are then, you know, act in certain ways as if we're subject to all these troubles and stuff. That's just one way of putting it. But we're certainly intensely identifying with an avatar in this scheme, most certainly. Now, we can see that all avatars are mere pretense, certainly. And then that frees us up from the delusion to a large extent. So we're not arguing against anything that anyone said, but we're giving sort of a more robust context, and clarifying certain areas, you know, like that, and seeing it from a certain perspective here. So it's just, you know, eternal life is self-validating. Eternal life is self-validating. It doesn't need any validation. We don't need to validate it. Neither naming nor explaining nor validating. Neither naming, explaining nor validating. Wow. I am light. I am light. I am light. Wow. We could do it that way. Neither naming, explaining nor validating. Wow. Neither naming, explaining, nor validating. Wow. I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow. Try practicing like that. Neither naming, nor explaining, nor validating. Wow. I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow. I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow. Neither naming, nor explaining, nor validating. Wow. I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow. Just loving, unsubjugating eternal life. And wow, neither naming, explaining, nor validating. Wow. I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow. Just loving, self-validating, non-subjugating eternal life. And wow. Just loving, self-validating, eternal life. And wow. Just loving, self-validating, eternal life. And wow. Just loving, self-validating. Imagine how wonderful it is you're experiencing something, and there's zero need for to validate that in any way. Zero need to validate it in any way. Zero need to validate in any way. How are we doing here? Zero need to validate it in any way. Wow. Glad it's Thursday. Only one more day of having to work. I got to do some things tomorrow. But then I don't know what I'm going to do on the weekend. Holy cow. How am I going to bounce back from this? You know, that's the question, because food doesn't seem to do it. Just hope that somehow, psychologically, there's some sort of shift that seems to, you know, dispel this. Be able to dispel it somehow. Well, the way to do that is just to realize you don't need to keep try to work on doing anything with the world. Okay, so you don't need to feel how the world feels in order to work on it. You see, you don't need that anymore. And that would then dissipate it. I'm sort of like holding on to this feeling so I can work on it. So I got a feeling for it, you know, what's going on in the world. But that's just, it's too ruinous to do. So we can just let go of that feeling so we no longer are, you know, don't really have the feel of the world anymore. I think that's what has to be done. So it's just this unsubjugating eternal life. And wow, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. And wow, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. And wow, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. And wow, I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow, that's a good one. Just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. And wow, I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow, I am light, I am light, I am light. Wow. So, I mean, I can't even hit swing a golf club right now. I don't even feel, you know, what I did today was I tried to do some push-ups, just gas station push-ups on those protective bars they have for the pumps. Boy, I could hardly do any. It's like crazy. I said, oh my gosh, I'm, you know, so this COVID really depletes your strength. It really, really does. I used to be able to do sets of 50, easy. I do, you know, just, I could do so many. And now I realize, wow, I'm just a shell of what I used to be just a couple of years ago before COVID. I was in such great shape. And now I'm just feeble, you know, feeble. I said, oh gosh, that's horrible. So maybe that tired me out because I tried, like, I did some sets of five, or I tried to do five and then do some more. But I could really feel it. And just like, oh my gosh, it's bad. And just the strength, you don't have the strength. You cannot generate strength, really. But again, this is the feeling of this world. No matter how much you work out strength-wise, it's never going to be strong. It's not strong enough. And, you know, and it's feeling like this weakness comes upon you. Like, oh, I'm not strong enough. I'm weak now. We cannot really deal with the intrusions into our casual lifestyle, casual affluence lifestyle. The intrusions are so extreme. And you can feel that, like, in the malls and various places, where the grab and runs and smash and grab and all that stuff. And someone steals $20,000 worth of jewelry. Nobody does a thing. Everyone goes, ah, don't even call the police. Nothing like that. So in other words, that's an extreme incursion incursion into the casual affluent lifestyle. As people think here now, they think they can just come and just seize it, you know, expropriate it for themselves without, you know, all the background that built that up, all the huge effort, thousands of years of effort to build this up, they just can come in and just take it, seize it. You know, how long is that going to last? Go gamble it away. You know, there's a ton of gambling going on in the world now. It's just, that's another super incursion. You know, I was brought up gambling as an absolute no-no. There was only in Nevada, and everyone else, it was illegal to gamble, totally illegal. So the idea of gambling, it's a super sin, so to speak. Yeah, but now it's like just being promoted everywhere, totally promoting it everywhere. That's just mind-blowing. It used to be baseball players, athletes, they could not have any association with gambling whatsoever, or they'd be banned for life from the sport. Now they can just openly promote gambling, these athletes. That's just an incredible decline, you might say. I mean, when gambling gets a hold of a culture, that culture is doomed. It is doomed. That's a sure sign of doom. It's kind of like, you know, physicians look for certain signs of, you know, you're doomed, your health is doomed. Well, when you got a culture that not only tolerates gambling, but exploits it, that promotes it, etc., that culture is doomed. It is doomed. Drugs is another one, right? So many different signs that a culture is doomed, and we have them all. We have all those signs now. And so we tried our very best to stop it, and it didn't work. So now you got to realize that this the purpose of this universe, what it really is, and it's just, you know, you cannot persuade people to not do it. You can't do it directly. They have to realize that it's not doable. The purpose is not reachable, and we don't need to do it. And that's very difficult. That's very difficult. Yeah, you can sober somebody up temporarily, but they'll go back to it. They'll go back to it. I've seen so many people just, you know, they go back to it because they think they need to. I think they need this suffering and ruination. We don't. So I'm certain of that. We don't need to try and convince the Prime Creator that it's subject to ruination, because the Prime Creator is not defective. So we don't need to try to get rid of the Prime Creator. So we don't need to put on a song and dance of ruination at all. Don't need to do it, and it's totally totally useless and unneeded. Totally useless and unneeded. But getting to that is not so difficult. People are resistant to it. They're paranoid. Hey, if I hear that, I might stop pretending. I don't know what to do. So it's a tricky situation. It's not so just easy just hearing this. You have to gradually ease yourself past the paranoia that you won't know how to function. That's a difficult one, because in this world, we're not called upon to function like we function in reality. Just the opposite. We're pretending that we can't function in reality here. So it's you know, difficult to get reassured that we can function if we stop pretending, stop acting, just be ourselves. You know, just be our eternal, unsubjugating, eternal lifing selves. You know, how would we function that way? So anyway, we keep on going in the right direction here. And as fast as possible. It's not easy right now. Not supposed to be easy. That's for sure. This morning I had a hard time coming up with a practice. I said, I can't get out of bed without a practice. I'm going to be doomed today. And so fortunately, I got one and started working on it. Wow. Turned out to be a great practice. Just unsubjugating eternal life. And wow. Neither naming, explaining, nor validating. Wow. Neither naming nor explaining, neither naming, explaining, or validating. Wow. Unsubjugating eternal life. And wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life. And wow. Just unsubjugating eternal life. Neither naming, explaining, or validating. Wow. Just loving, unsubjugating eternal life. And wow. I am life. I am life. I am life. Wow. I am life. I am life. I am life. Wow. I'd love to have a lot of energy. If I did, I'd be dancing and singing this, you know. Maybe it's preventing me from doing that right now. Maybe it's too dangerous to do that. I'd like to stand on a corner with a sign, you know, and say, yeah, repent, the end is at hand, you know, and you say, you know, but prevented from doing anything like that. Too tired to do that. And you want to witness to people right now, but they may not be in a mood to be witnessed to. That is quite possible. I took out some of the light. What can I do with this? Yeah, neither naming, explaining, or validating. Wow. Just loving, unsubjugating eternal life. And wow. Just loving, unsubjugating eternal life. And wow. Just loving, unsubjugating eternal life. And wow. Yeah. And our culture has been encroached upon previously many, many times, and it's never been the same, from that. It's not like we ever went back to way the what we used to have. No, it's been a gradual process of diminishment, 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 diminishment. But now that diminishment is vastly speeded up, vastly accelerated. And so we're kind of used to saying, well, it's not, and hopefully it doesn't change too much, too fast, and things like that. Well, it is. It is right now. So don't just sit back and think that, you can, it won't happen very quickly. It's going to happen quickly. It is happening quickly. It is happening quickly. It's just, wow. When you walk into a car dealership and there's no cars, you just say, whoa. But talking with people, and people say, yeah. A lot of, some people are actually really shocked and stunned by it. I say, what? I was shocked by it. Someone just got a Toyota truck. I asked him, how'd you get it? And he said, well, I did some work at the manager of a Toyota dealership, and so they told me that there was three trucks coming in that weren't yet claimed, so he got me one. That's the only way to get it. You had an interconnection there, had an interconnection with the actual manager of the dealership. Otherwise, you're paying these surcharges, you're paying all this extra money for cars, like, let's say 10,000 extra. So, and someone else said they just bought a car, and they paid so much more for it. Had, they have to order it way in advance. I mean, who could just plop down all this? I don't know how it works, but you gotta have a lot of money to buy a car. People realize you can't. Buying new cars right now is so problematic and expensive. So expensive. And if you have one, you can sell it for more than you bought it for. Sure, if it's low mileage, if you have a low mileage used car, you can sell it for more than you bought it for new at this point. So, how does the lower middle class keep up with that? You can't. And so they're scrambling for used cars. I hear all sorts of stories. People got a great deal on, but how long does that last? I mean, it's just, you just have to have grace. I mean, if grace isn't running your life, then you got no chance, it seems like right now. The affluent class can keep thinking that they can just buy their way through it all, which, may not be the case going forward. Actually, could be someone could slam the brakes on things. Someone could slam the brakes on things, just it, absolutely, and that would cause a sudden change. So we just say, neither naming nor explaining, just self-validating. Wow. Neither naming nor explaining nor validating. Wow. Neither naming, explaining, nor validating. Wow. Just unsubjugating eternal lifing. Wow. So just self-validating eternal lifing. Wow. Just self-validating eternal lifing. Wow. It's self-validating. We don't even know what that's like. So when we experience it, we say something, this is so unusual. Why? Because it's self-validating. It's self-validating. Another did something good this morning. I had to wash this vehicle. It's not my car, but it's one that I drive. I have access to, and it was so dirty because I haven't been driving it. It's just so filthy. I took a car wash, washed it, came back, and I remember I had this old what do you call it? Huh? I can't. The word is wow. It's a car. You put a, what is it called? Crazy, had a block there. Anyway, I covered a car cover. I guess you just call it a car cover. Yeah, I covered it with this old car cover, so it doesn't get so dusty and dirty. Man, it's amazing how if the car's outside, how bad it gets. And so now I'm going to keep it clean by putting that car cover on it. Like, I never thought of doing that before. Isn't that amazing? It's an old one. It belongs to someone else, and they don't use it. And so I said, why not just put it on this car? It's made for some other car, but actually fit this car perfectly. Fit it great. I said, wow, okay. In business now. So when next time I want to drive, just take it off, and the car is going to be just as clean as when I put it on. And I won't have to, it's terrible driving a car around town where it's just completely filthy. I said, I can't drive. I can't do this. Got to get a car, go in the car wash here. But the car wash is now, jumped from, used to get it for $8. It's now $12 as opposed to $8. Yeah. Just a little while ago it was 11. And when today? 12 now. See, so everything is just going up like that. Gas has gone down a little bit. We'll see how long that lasts. Wow. But that's a good thing. I said, you know, that was really smart. Sort of like it's a feeling of eternal life. You keep that feeling, right? It's like you just put like a car cover on you, how you feel. And it's self-validating. It's self-validating. You don't need to look for validation anywhere else. So you don't say, okay, I need to validate this. Let me let go of this experiencing and let me go validate it now. Let me talk to some people, see if they can validate this for me. No, it's self-validating. It's self-validating. Remember, unsubjugating eternal life, unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life, and wow, unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life, and wow, unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life, and wow, just unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life, and wow, just unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life, and wow, just loving, 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 unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life, and wow, yeah, like that. So that possibility of putting a car cover on has been here for quite some time, really. I just suddenly realized, put two and two together, I said, hey, wait a minute. Just because this car cover is for another car doesn't mean it won't fit this one. Let's see if it fits, and it fit perfectly. I said, hey, I could have been doing this all along. I mean, I only drive the car like once every 2 weeks or something like that, not very often at all. So, you know, what the heck? Keep it clean. Keep it clean. No brainer. But, you know, oftentimes you'll suddenly just recognize, hey, I can do this. You know, it's a no brainer, but you had never even thought about doing it before. So that's grace. Grace is prompting you. Say, hey, what about this idea? You go, huh? What? Really? Can I do that? I thought I'd thrown it out, but I hadn't. It's like, ah, great. And like practicing like we're doing, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life, and wow. Most people say, hey, I never even thought I could even do that. But like, oh, yeah, I could do that. I could actually practice like this. This causes you like a change in your life. You say, hey, wait a minute. I could have always been doing this. I was just pretending that I was under a spell of limitation and ruination in order to convince the prime creator that this spell is actually real. So it puts a spell on the prime creator and it self-destructs. You see how it works here? This COVID, see, there's another thing. The way that it is right now, it seems like it's getting around all the vaccines, getting around everything, and you can catch it like within a month's time after you've had it once. You can get it, like say 3 weeks. Only your immunity lasts like 3 weeks, and you get it again, and you get it again, and again. A lot of people are getting it many times. Actually, I've had it twice now. A lot of people have had it 4, 5, 6 times actually, and some even more. And they say that's cumulative negative effects on your health when that happens. Very bad. So we got this scenario where, you know, these variants keep getting around the vaccine, they keep getting around whatever, you know, our antibodies and natural antibodies. Everybody say natural antibodies, you know, great, well, until, you know, BA5 comes around and then it's like, uh-oh, this doesn't work anymore. So that's a nasty scenario. You know, there's no way to, other, we can't sugarcoat this. I mean, it is a nasty scenario. This is the way the world is, this is the way it's walking right now. So, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life. And wow, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating, eternal life. And wow, neither naming nor explaining, I am light. Wow, neither naming nor explaining, I am light. Wow, neither naming nor explaining, I am light. Wow, where are we at here? Neither naming nor explaining, I am light. Wow, neither naming nor explaining, I am light. Wow, neither naming nor explaining, I am light. Wow. But there's a whole lot of people in the U.S. that just simply have their heads in the sand. And they say, well, nothing's wrong. What are you talking about? Denial. They're in denial. They say, nothing. I don't want anything to mess with my casual affluence. Yeah, this lifestyle that Americans had. Still, you know, vacationing and this and everything's fine. Everything's great. What are you guys talking about? Yeah, and so they just are clinging to this because they don't have nothing else to cling to, right? Because they haven't listened to grace telling them, hey, you know, there's these cycles here, and we're going into this ruination cycle, and you're not going to like it. So let's see, you know, let's aim for what is not subjugated to any limitation or ruination whatsoever, eternal lifing. They don't listen to that. They just stick their head in the sand and say, you know, nothing to see here. This is incredible. Like, everything's fine here. Yeah. And we look at them and say, are you crazy? What are you talking about? It's just like extreme denial of what's going on, the act that's going on here. We don't need to deny the act. We're acting, but it's stupid to deny the acting. You know, the people are putting on an act. Ruination, limitation, ruination. They certainly are acting this way. Yes, it's all an act, but it still is an act. It's not like there isn't any act going on. Yes, there is. There's certainly acting going on here. So you can say sickness is an act. Yes, it is. But someone's acting very sick. Yes, they are. You can't say, no, they're not acting sick. Yes, they are acting sick. Now, that doesn't affect eternal lifing at all. That is true. But we're trying to affect eternal lifing. That is also true. We're certainly attempting to. That's true. That's a fact. That's a fact. So we're not trying to deny the facts of the situation. We are certainly trying to convince the prime creator to self-destruct. The fact that we can never succeed at it means we don't need to do it. And the it's not having any effect, and we don't need to do it. That's true. But we are certainly trying to do it. So I haven't been reading much of anything that anyone else says on the internet right now, except Ram Maharshi. I always find that to be helpful. But as far as you know, people in the world, their spiritual ideas, I'm not even paying attention to it at all, because it's so much denial going on. So much denial. It's amazing. It's astonishing that they cannot accept that, you know, that there's all this acting going on of ruination in the world. They think they know everything's just great. Great. I mean, it's kind of the back of the 1960s or 50s or 70s or something. I don't know. It's really weird. So you got to walk and chew gum at the same time. Yeah, there's a terrible act going on now. We're acting, you know, extreme avalanche of ruination's coming. We're acting it out. There's many in this world who are certainly acting that out. And also, it's not needed. We don't need to do this, and it's never going to be successful. And we certainly, therefore, can decide to stop volunteering to act out, try to cast this spell upon the Prime Creator. We don't have to participate in that. So you can do both of those things. Yeah, there is all this acting going on, but I don't have to participate in it anymore. I have an option to not participate in it. At least that's how I see the situation. That's how it's presented to me in this revelation. I think that's very fair, very reasonable and fair. So people can continue. I can't prevent them. I don't want to prevent other people. I can't force other people to stop acting because they think it's necessary. They think the prime creator is defective, therefore we have to get rid of it. So they think this is absolutely necessary, and so we've got to find a way to do it. And I'm saying, I know for sure the prime creator is not defective, so there is no reason to do this whatsoever. Plus, there isn't any way to convince the prime creator to self-destruct, not possible. So on both accounts, got to re-examine our commitment to this, pre-acting that we're doing, this pretending that we're doing. And gradually, move away from it and say, hey, I really don't need to keep doing this. It's not necessary. But certainly not saying others can't keep trying if they want to. Sure, sure. We're not trying to prevent them from doing that. We're just, easing off the stage, so to speak, of all this stuff. Easing into a much, much better scenario. Much, much better scenarios. Unsubjugating eternal life. Wow, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. Wow, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. Wow, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. Wow, just loving, unsubjugating, self-validating eternal life. Wow, getting ready for that. Which is much better than the casual affluence of recent decades. Much, much, much better. It's not subject to limitation and ruination. It's not subject to that. It's not subjugated to anything at all. It's self-validating. So that's way better. Whereas this volatility of this world, obviously, is an extremely volatile place. The universe is extremely volatile. And the idea that, things are just going to continue on, doesn't happen. Look at history. Doesn't happen. So we've kind of been in it like a trance or something, saying, everything's just going to continue like it. No, the encroachment is everywhere. The encroachment is intense. Intense encroachment has taken place. And people just kind of, they don't even... They don't want to know about it. They don't want to be told about it. If you tell them, they'll get very upset. You spoiled my mood. No encroachment's taking place on this. But that's a setup for ruination. You see, to pretend that happiness is not going to be subjected to pretend unhappiness is a delusion. That's the setup that we say we front load deathing with lifing. So this front loaded lifing that we're strolling around in casual affluence. So this wonderful lifing here. That's all just a setup so that it can be torn down by deathing. So those people are playing along with that. They're just playing along with that. They don't want to realize what's going on and say just stop the whole thing. And I say nothing bad can happen to me. Whoops. Suddenly, sudden ruination strikes them. Pride goeth before a fall, so to speak. Vanity, pride goeth before a fall. Not to say that grace can't and won't help us. It certainly will help us. I'm counting on that. That's the only thing I have to count on right now. And, how do you get a vehicle these days, really? I don't know. Certainly don't want to drive a lousy vehicle. I've done that before. Really, really, really not a good idea. Terrible idea. It was a nightmare. I thought it was like cool, to have that. When you're young, it's like you're like, I don't know, something about it. But no, when you get older, you want your vehicle, whatever you're driving, you want it to be very reliable, actually safe and reliable. So, the idea you can go buy a new car right now. Right. Somebody just bought an electric car, used the Bolt that had its battery, recall. So they couldn't buy him for a while or something. Someone didn't want to deal with it and they sold it, I guess. And it was like super low mileage, incredibly low mileage. So then he went and got the new recall, got the new battery pack on recall free. So now he's got a car with extremely low mileage with the new battery pack. Pretty sharp there. So that is a sharp one. So but are electrics going to be like dirt cheap? I haven't seen that. Maybe someday. But you can't really wait. You can't like wait around for everything to get cheap. It's like We gotta, like, it's weird, like looking on Google Maps, for somehow it got shifted over to public transportation for me. So I look up a place and it says, you can get there in 1 hour, 1 hour and 7 minutes or something. I say, wait a minute, it's just like a couple miles away or something, And so they just kept giving me all these public transit ways of getting there. I didn't realize what was going on. I said, what are you doing? What are you talking about? They've got all these, we grab, this and go transfer here, transfer here, transfer here, transfer here, transfer here, transfer, and then you'll get there in like 1 hour and 10 minutes from now. It's like really difficult here. It's like crazy. So they're trying to get everybody, really, these people who are trying to get everyone to take public transport, are they taking public transport? No. They got a little garage full of Teslas. That's for sure. They just want the streets to be unclogged for themselves, so they can zoom around and get someplace really, really easily and fast, without any, other vehicles on the road. Pretty interesting. Yeah, got but I finally figured out, oh, they somehow they moved me off of like the car option. You can't. No, you got to go public transport option. I don't remember ever changing that option. I didn't. So maybe they're trying to just like Google Maps is just say, hey, hint, hint, hint. You got to start taking public transport everywhere. Well, that's great unless you're like have to deliver all sorts of goods and things to people and things. It doesn't help out there. So there's an encroachment right there in your way of life, isn't it? Hey, folks, I gotta stop driving. Oh, let them eat cake. Let them eat cake. Just buy a brand new Tesla. Come on, get with the program here, folks. Come on. Just go in there and say, look, I'm supposed to drive electric. Just give me the car. I don't think that's gonna work. I don't think that's gonna work. Plus the cost of charging it, right, and maintenance. I don't want to drive one of those things. It's the idea of all the technological interface you have to go through with the Tesla, for instance. It's just a nightmare. I can't even imagine having to do that. They just keep track of every last thing you do, and you have to, upgrade your software, and there's all sorts of, tech things and programs and computer stuff you have to go through. I got no time for any of that stuff. Zero interest in that. Been there, done that, but technology, been there, done that. It's over. For me, technology's finished, done with it. No interest in going back to it. Really, that's my feeling. Completely done. If I never seen a technology again, it won't bother me at all. Maybe it's like some antique in a museum or something. Oh yeah, I remember we used to use those phones. That was so weird. Didn't like that really at all. It was terrible. It's just technology. They think like we're just going to be in love with it forever. No chance. No chance. It's really been the most horrible experience. The wow factor has long dissipated. The bloom has long been off the rose. The rose is just desiccated right now, utterly desiccated. We're supposed to say, look at that wonderful rose. No, it's completely desiccated. Zero interest in functioning in such a culture like that. It's just it has no compelling interest at all. So, the future again in this world is, it is what it is. But here we can say, just